Hello, friends at Virtual Reality Church. This is Pastor DJ. A lot of you have been asking for a video of the previous Sunday for the sermon, and we haven't set that up yet, but I thought I'd do a quick recap, maybe 4 or 5 minutes, go through the main points, the main highlights of the sermon. So I hope this is helpful to you. I hope that you enjoy it. Before I kind of go into the sermon recap, I got my screen here for some visuals for you, and we'll do this in Paris because why not? Right. And one thing before we do the recap, an announcement we made on Sunday is Virtual Reality Church Europe is right around the corner. A lot of you are from Germany and Great Britain. You've said, Pastor DJ, man, it's like 1 or 2 in the morning, and that's just really late for us. So we are launching a VR Church Europe experience, and we'll have some more details about that shortly. Well, we've been studying the life of Jesus Christ, and in specifically, we've been looking through the Gospel of John. John was a follower of Jesus Christ, and he wrote down the things that he saw and he heard. And this week, we are in John chapter 5. But before we hop into it, I really encourage you to download the YouVersion Bible app. This is a great app that I highly recommend because as we're jumping into John chapter 5 here to do the recap, you're going to miss a lot of the story, a lot of the context. So go back and read through it. Up to John chapter 5, and then you'll be caught up on, you know, what's going on. And this video really is for anybody. It doesn't have to be people from Virtual Reality Church. If you just want to follow along with what we're learning, that would be awesome too. So the title of last Sunday's message was Ignore the Haters. This is several parts we're going to do. It's from John chapter 5 and verse 8 through 21. And in a nutshell, God has a destiny for each and every one of you. You have talents, you have abilities, you have gifts infused inside of you from the divine. But there's going to be haters that are going to kind of rise up and try to talk you out of your dreams, talk you out of the destiny that God has for you. And John wrote this passage of scripture because he didn't want anything to get in the way. Your destiny is too important. The purpose that God has for you is way more important than what anybody else thinks. And here's the last verse that we read on the previous sermon. It said, instantly, the man was healed. He rolled up his sleeping mat and began walking. So just want to reiterate to go back and get the Bible app so you can catch up with what's going on. But in a nutshell, Jesus healed a man who was lame for almost like 40 years. Jesus asked this man an illuminating question. He illuminated the mind by asking him, do you want to get healed? And maybe the man didn't know before that was even a possibility or even an option. And so what we talked about last week was that healing is an option. Healing is for today. And Jesus's question is to illuminate our mind is, oh, that's a possibility. Oh, that's something that I can have today. Because some of you are going through illness, through disease, through sickness. And that could be physical, mental, or emotional. And what Jesus wants you to know is that healing is available for all of us. But here's what happened. The miracle happened on the Sabbath, so the Jewish leaders objected. Man, why is it that when you're trying to go to new levels in your life, when you're trying to rise to a new dimension or elevate or evolve your life, the trolls and the haters are going to come out of the woodwork and they're going to object. And John wrote this passage of scripture to protect your destiny because there's going to be haters and trolls in your life, and they're going to object to what God is doing. And I personally can't connect with this type of thinking because I barely have enough time to take care of myself. I barely have enough time to keep this all together, and then now I'm going to be all up in your business. But man, the haters and the trolls are going to object to what God is doing in your life. And they said to the man who was cured, you can't work on the Sabbath. The law doesn't allow you to carry that sleeping mat. Man, haters and trolls, they're going to tell you what you can't do. They're going to tell you what you're not allowed to do. And that's something we got to push out of our mind because God has a destiny that we need to fulfill. The man who healed me, Jesus, told me, pick up your mat and walk. And I love that. I love that because even if the haters and trolls are going to tell you what you can't do, what you're not allowed to do, Jesus is going to tell you what you can do. Man, pick up that mat and start walking. Well, they didn't like that. Look at the bottom, it says, who said such a thing as that, they demanded. Oh man, haters and trolls, they don't like new thoughts, new paradigms, anything that goes against their construct, they're going to be against. And they don't like new narratives. this challenge their way of life, their way of thinking. So we'll skip a few verses, and they find out that Jesus was the one that said such a thing. So the Jewish leaders began harassing Jesus for breaking the Sabbath rules. And that's the thing. You know, haters and trolls are going to tell you what you can't do, what you're not allowed to do. And once they see that you're still resolute in your mind and your heart, that you've set your face as flint to move forward in the destiny that God has for you, they're going to start harassing you. But Jesus replied, "My Father is always working, and so am I." I just love that phrase. My Father is always working, and so am I. Basically, Jesus is like, hey, listen, I'm just doing what God wants me to do. I'm just walking the path that God wants me to walk. You don't have to walk that path. You don't have to go that way, but God wants me to go that way. You worry about yourself, I got to do my thing. It's a powerful response from Jesus Christ. So Jesus explained further. He said, I tell you the truth. The Son can do nothing by himself. He does only what he sees the Father doing. Whatever the Father does, the Son also does. He's just kind of hammering the fact that, listen, I'm just doing what God has called me to do. If that's not what he called you to do, that's fine. You do you. I'm going to do me. I'm going to do this path that God has laid out. It doesn't matter if people think I'm crazy. It doesn't matter if people think I'm not good enough. God thinks I'm good enough. And God's going to empower me to do this work that he has. I love this passage of scripture. For the Father loves the Son and shows him everything he is doing. It's a beautiful passage because no matter what dreams we're following, what destiny we're trying to fulfill, it's based on a relationship of love. Our love for God and God's love for us. Oh man, the next verse is powerful. Jesus is building up to it. You haters, you trolls, if you're religiously arrogant, you better sit down, you better buckle up, because here's what he says. In fact, the Father will show him how to do even greater works than healing this man. Jesus was telling the religiously arrogant. He said, you think that was impressive? Man, I was just getting started. That was just a little warm up. I have greater works coming. And the same thing is true in your life. Maybe you've experienced a healing. Maybe you've experienced a blessing. Man, God is just getting started. He's just warming up in your life. You haven't seen anything yet. So the haters and trolls better get used to it, because God is going to do works that are going to leave you speechless. How do I know that? Look at the bottom of the verse. And he told those religiously arrogant people, then you will truly be astonished. Man, God's just getting started in your life. He's just warming up. And whatever he's going to do, the great work he's going to do in your life is going to leave you speechless. Not just you, but your haters and trolls are going to be astonished about what God is going to do. And John wrote this passage of scripture because we have a destiny to fulfill. We have a path that God wants us to follow. We have dreams waiting for us. And we can't let the naysayers, we can't let the trolls, and we can't let the haters get in the way of what all that God has for us.